So this is demonstration for challenge assignment 2, and here is a board and it's building and it's uploading. So we are stopped at main and we will run the code by pressing F8 button, which is for continue execution. As we can see, a green line is turned on, which shows that burglar alarm is off. So we will try to ring bell first. So this is normal bell execution. Now we will turn on the burglar alarm. And we can see that burglar alarm is running. You can snooze the burglar alarm by pressing port 1.4. And we can try again. So this is how it will run. And one more thing is I want to show is that pressing doorbell button will not stop or interrupt the burglar alarm. Now I'll stop this, and now because one interrupt was pending, the doorbell rang after the burglar alarm was snoozed. Now I'll just turn on the flashlight for camera and I will demonstrate fire alarm. So this is sound for fire alarm, which we need to reset by pressing system reset button. And once the system is reset, the burglar alarm defaults to disable and we have to enable it manually. Now if the burglar alarm is started and we put some more light, the alarm mode will switch from burglar to fire alarm because that has higher priority. And I will reset the system here, and as we can see, once it is disabled, it does not fire any burglar alarm. And this is just normal 2 second bell. So this is a hardware demo. Now we will switch to code demo. And this is me. Hi. Okay, so now we'll go and do the code walkthrough. As we can see, we are starting with main function here, and I will walk you through the main function. So first thing we do is holding the watchdog timer and disabling the interrupts. After that, we will initialize the clocks using init clocks function, where we are setting all the frequencies to 3 megahertz. Going back, we have initialization of all the buttons, where we are setting pin 1.1 for enabling disabling the burglar alarm, setting pin 3.5 for doorbell, and setting pin 1.4 to snooze the burglar alarm. Going back, after that we will initialize the LED, where we are setting pin port 2 point pin 6 as output and port 2 pin 4 as output, and port 2.6 is red LED, point 2.4 is green LED. After that we will initialize the ADC for microphone, where we are going to use port 4 pin 3, and we are setting it as a triary function. Here we are setting up the ADC control parameters and ADC flags, and setting the source as A10, and we are enabling all the interrupts here, disabling the interrupts because we don't want to use it in interrupt mode as of now. After that, we are starting the light sensor and burglar sensor ADC sampling. In this, what we are going to do is we have timer A configuration, which is running in continuous mode and up mode. So now whenever the timer A1 will reach to 0, it will call the ISR of timer A, timer A10. So this is like for running the periodic task of checking for fire and checking for burglar. So this is our initialization. After that, as per requirements, we are deactivating the burglar alarm, and in deactivating the burglar alarm code, we are setting the output of green and red LEDs. This function, when passed 0 for deactivation, will enable the burglar alarm module. It will just set this flag burglar module active as 1 or 0, and it will also switch the green and red LEDs. Okay, sorry for the loss of the file. After all the initialization is completed, we are going to start the watchdog timer, and because our while loop is starting, which is going to run on continuous basis, and before that entering the while loop, we are also going to start all the interrupts. As our program has completed the initialization and now going to be in runtime mode, so for each while loop, first thing we do is reset watchdog timer, because that's the highest priority task always in round robin or the scheduling. And this task will be executed always, because it's always available to be executed. After that, we are checking the first priority task, the highest priority task, which has to be executed if it is requested. So first we will check if the fire alarm is requested. If it is requested, then we will set the system alert level as 3 and we will ring the fire alarm. Now there is interesting code in this function, ring fire alarm, which is in tone.c file. So now we consider the speaker as a resource which is used by 3 different tasks. First is doorbell, second is burglar alarm, and third is fire alarm. So now, because this is running in asynchronous mode, while the ring fire alarm function is called, the speaker might be used by some other process already. So we are just waiting for the speaker in use task to complete, and speaker in use is a global variable, not a global variable, but it is a static variable which is available only in this file, because the tone.c is the only file which is going to use this variable. So this is just sanity check that we don't corrupt the sounds. So while the speaker is in use, it will wait for an interrupt. Now why it is waiting for an interrupt is also we will cover it later, but what it is doing is it will set the speaker in use as 1, that means speaker is being used. Then it will generate tone of 2000 hertz for 500 milliseconds, and again generate tone of 1500 hertz for 500 milliseconds. So this will take around 1 second to complete, but this will keep running in a while loop because we are running this on a continuous basis. Similarly, we have ring the burglar alarm code here, and now if the fire alarm is requested, then only fire alarm will ring. All other will go into the else block and it will never run if fire alarm is requested. Then comes the second priority task, which is burglar alarm. And then there is third task, which is bell requested. Now, this is a task which runs for longer time, like 2 seconds. So whenever the bell is requested, we will call ring bell function. Now this will run approximately for 0.2 seconds or 0.4 seconds maybe. So it's basically 0.4 seconds basically, so that we run this code 5 times and then we set the bell requested as 0. So what will happen whenever the bell is requested, the while loop will run 5 times and each time it will increase the count of bell requested variable by 1. When bell requested variable becomes 5, then the bell requested will become 0. So this is just to enable the preempting of bell if something else is running. And if there is nothing else to do, we will not do anything. Now we will go to ISRs. So whenever there is port 3 ISR, which is for doorbell press button, we will set the variable bell requested to 1. We just saw it back here. And before doing all this, it will first disable the interrupt, and at the time of exiting it will enable the interrupt. And it also has a delay of 200 milliseconds. Whenever there is a interrupt on port 1, we have two cases. If pin 1 was the source of interrupt, then we are going to toggle the module of burglar alarm. So we'll deactivate or activate the burglar alarm module. If the pin 4 is pressed, then we are going to set the burglar alarm requested is equal to 0. That means it's going to snooze the burglar alarm. And this is a repetitive task which is going to run for a timer A1 interrupt whenever timer A1 is reaching to 0 on periodic basis. This will be called. So first what it will do is it will read the lux, that means ambient light, and if it is greater than the fire threshold, it will request the fire alarm. And the second task it will do is it will read the ADC of microphone, and it will try to see if the ADC result is greater than the threshold or less than the lower threshold, then it will request the burglar alarm. And this function will be called on continuous basis. Now what I want to show you next is how we are implementing the optimization. So whenever there is a function as a ring bell, what it will do, it will generate tone of 440 hertz for some milliseconds, and then the immediate statement is wait for interrupt. So now we will see what is there in tone. So what tone function does is it will start, it will generate the PWM using timer A0, and it will set the timer 32 with some count which is related to the parameter we passed as milliseconds. So since our clock frequency is 3 megahertz, we are setting 3000 into milliseconds count. It will enable the interrupt and it will start the timer of timer 32 0. Whenever this timer 32 is expired, it will clear the interrupt flag and it will stop the PWM timer. So exactly for that amount of time, a PWM will be generated, and as we go back, an interrupt will be generated and which will be served here. It will send the tone command for second part of the bell. So we are using three frequencies here, 440, 550 and 660, which is a major triad in music. This is the way how I am implementing the optimized code with sleep.